trouble all my day. I bid farewell to old Kentucky, the plains where high.
Hey, how's it going? Mike Canfield. I decided to go for a little ride today. We just got out of a 2 week, it felt like 2 weeks anyway, really deep freeze. Like, couldn't go fishing, couldn't go sledding, so first time out in a while. I left this morning. It was still 24 below. When I left at about 5 a.m. because it's about a 2 hour ride to where I want to go trout fishing today. So, got out here. Never been to this area of this lake before. It is mapped on Navionics, but it's not mapped well because every time I went to a spot, a hump where I thought should be about 70 feet, it was 160 feet. So, and when I got out here, I couldn't believe how cold it was. Felt colder than 24 below. Could be that I just got chilled on the way. But anyway, I found a spot that's just off an island. I'm reading 88 feet here. Not too far this way. I was 160 feet, so I don't know. It's a good spot. I had to get the shack up. I was getting pretty cold. So I had all my camera gear just got thawed out, so thought I'd take a quick video. It's supposed to be a nice day today. It's the sun just started hitting the shack and came out, and I had one trout up at about 20 feet, so and it hit a couple times, but I couldn't hook up. And then just a little while ago, I was went right down to the bottom. It's coming up, just jigging it on the jig up. I got one hit and I hooked him up, and not a bad lake trout there. So the limit for lake trout is two. So I got one, so I'm doing in pretty good shape. I'm gonna keep trying. The one I got it on here is a spoon, so I'm gonna keep trying the spoon for a while. I got a tube jig over in the other hole here as my set line. Like I said, it's a 2 hour ride back, so it's 9 o'clock already right now. Yeah, I've been gone for 4 hours already, but I really want to try this part of the lake. We'll see. It's kind of more about the ride than anything. I'm a little disappointed because the Navionics app showed that the lake was in was really good detail, and I was pretty excited to try a few spots. And then I got out here, and every time I drilled a hole, it was 160 feet. When I was looking for about 70 feet. So that was a little frustrating. Every time I'd move, drill, and anywhere from 180 to 160 feet. So. Which is just a little too deep for me to fish. It's there could be trout there, but I'm kind of looking for some structure. So we'll try here. Already a successful day. You get one good trout, you're in good shape. So see if I can hook. Well, I think I got a nice one on here. I just saw it on my graph. Give it a couple jigs. I got the camera, I see not quite in the right spot, but it's gonna go for a run, I think. There we go. I think it's a pretty good one. This is on that red tube jig I was talking about earlier. It's got a stinger hook on it. Trout have hard mouths, so a stinger hook really helps. That single hook is pretty hard to ram in sometimes. I see my leader, but he's not really ready to come through the hole. Oh, gotta look at him. Woo! Come on, baby. Yeah. your head through there. Get your head through there. No. Jeez. There he goes. He's good size. I don't know. The last one did this too. They didn't fight much until right to the hole, and then fought a lot after that. Once he got close to the hole, it was really fighting. Let's see with this one. I think it's bigger than the last one. Come on. Must be hooked up decently. Of course, you should never say that while you're fighting a fish. Oh, get out of here. I got this braided line on here, so hopefully, you know, it does less chance of cutting on the side of the hole. But then it also, I have a mono leader, so once you get close to the mono leader, which I now have, you're more at risk of cutting it. Oh boy, it's a nice one. Come on. Nope. No. Oh, geez. He must have swam up for a second. I thought I lost him. Holy man. Woo. Oh, why do I see him already? I think I got twisted up. Oh, there he goes. Come on. Come on. Oh, come here, you. Come on. Oh! Woo! That's a nice one right there. That's a nice laker. Woo! Just a beaut. Yeah, you gotta see. You got twisted up there. Oh! That's what... That's why you get up at 5 in the morning, go for a 2-hour sled ride in the freezing cold, right there. Oh boy, beautiful, beautiful fish. Very nice. Happy about that one. Just hooked up another one. I'm just fishing, catch and release now. I got my 2 trout. I got on a... Put a gold spoon on to try, since I'm just doing catch and release. Thought I'd try something a little different. Again, from that West Side bait and tackle mystery box. Had what I hit earlier. It's a little guy, I think. Whoa! You know what? He's not so little. He just, again, they're not fighting till they get right to the hole. This guy just basically swam up the hole. Jeez. He's not ready to come through. I don't really want to hook myself. Come here. Come here. Alright. Oh. Alright. Ha! Hooked himself right under the lip. He hit this spoon a couple times. There we go. A gold spoon. I had a chunk of meat on it. Nice laker. All right, back you go. Oh, get down the hole. There he goes. Ah, another nice one. That's 3 today, and 3 today, missed quite a few as well. There's lots of bites and stuff, but sometimes trout are hard to get hooked up. Okay, hold on for the day. It's about 11:30. Got 3 lakers. Missed a bunch. There was lots of action during the day. It was great. Good day, especially considering I've never been here before. And the Navionics wasn't very accurate, so I kind of had a guess a little bit. But worked out, turned out to be a beautiful day. It's a little breezy right now, but it's
It's a lot warmer than it was this morning when I got here. I was freezing this morning, but it's really nice now. I thought I had to end the video today with just kind of showing, for those that are interested in doing a lot of ice fishing and going long distances, you know, if you can, you want to get everything on your snow machine. You don't want to pull a sleigh if you don't have to. I mean, it's convenient to pull a sleigh. You can fit a lot more gear for sure, but if you're going to drive 2 hours and the lake's rough, if you can get everything on your sled, that's the best. Mine's a two up that I take off, and I've got figured out here lots of ways of doing it though. So I'm going to show how this is done. These clam insulated shacks are great too. I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of the good brands out there too, but I've always had clam and it works really well. Got to be insulated though if you're up, if you're in cold weather. They're not insulated. They still work, but you get not as warm obviously, and you get condensation inside. So if you can, insulated is best. Holding these up's a bit of an art too. When you first get them, you learn real quick there's only one way of doing it. I broke a couple poles before I figured out exactly how to do it, but that was it. What's nice about these two, it's, you know, it's a one-person job. They go up and down with one person doing it, so a little bit of effort, but to be comfortable, it's worth it. I'm when I was younger, I definitely was, I don't know, I didn't mind being as cold, but I hate being cold. It's so much more enjoyable when you're ice fishing and you're not freezing. This is the way to go. The nice thing about these clams, the new ones, they don't make the bag, you know, just big enough to fit, because when it gets iced up and cold, you don't want to be messing around with a bag like your traditional tent. Seems like those things never go back in the bags. This one goes back in the bag fairly well. Of course, you don't want the bag too big.